Onto something I think much more uplifting. Premiering tonight is a new show that's more than 65,000 years in the making. The First Inventors goes back in time to explore how Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander life flourished thanks to countless innovations and inventions, and how those, how we can apply those techniques today. Have a look.
The first Australians had to organise themselves. They built systems that would not only sustain them locally, but would facilitate trade, travel, and the exchange of ideas across vast distances. What our ancestors invented was a sophisticated and robust civilization in a deeply connected continent.
And the director of the First Inventors, Larissa Behrendt, joins us now.
Yes, thank you.
Hey, what a great idea this is. This looks great. What is the coolest invention that you discovered working on the show?
Oh, look, that's a really hard question to answer because there was so many. And I guess I felt like I really knew a lot about my culture, but I found out so much more. I think for me, perhaps it was some of the stories that we looked at that showed how strong our oral history is today, that actually things that people might think are dreamtime stories or creation stories actually talk about historic events that we can trace right back to the Ice Age. That was pretty incredible. And, of course, a volcano that was turned into eel traps is on the first episode, and that was pretty fascinating as well.
I mean, what else do you do with a volcano?
Exactly.
Well, what I found really fascinating is how your ancestors communicated over really long distances, especially through message sticks. What are they?
So message sticks were pieces of wood mostly, and they would have carvings on them, and the markings actually meant things. They could mean times of the year or particular dates, and they could mean particular places. So they were ways in which Aboriginal people communicated across the country. If you know how to read it, it makes complete sense.
Larissa, I feel like this should totally change the way we think about ancient Indigenous culture. Should it? And did it change the way you thought about your ancestors and your culture?
It's always struck me that people aren't more curious as to why it is that we're the world's oldest living culture. And what I think was really profound for me in doing these stories was that I realised that the very values and processes that allowed us to live so harmoniously with our land and our country actually still hold a lot of wisdom for the big issues that are facing us today. Climate change, the fragility of democracy. I mean, I would hope that we don't see these cultures as ancient, because certainly we see them as living. And what I hope is that it broadens people's perspectives on the knowledges that sit within them and how they might actually apply to the way we think about living in the future.
It's always an exciting thing to be surprised and enlightened in the process. This sounds like it'll do just that. The First Inventors premieres tonight, both on Network 10 and NITV, right after MasterChef. Larissa, thanks so much.
Thank you so much.